I'm back for round two, man. I got it. I told y'all, when it's going down, it's going down. It's going down. I got the DJ.
4, 3, 2, 2.
A two-step, a two-step.
What up?
Hold on. How we doing?
Hey.
Yes, indeed. Hype man, Ricky, in the place to be with the motherfucking. All right.
What up, bro?
What's popping, my DJ bro? All right, people. Let me just tell y'all right now. This is my brother, DJ Montay. You know what I'm saying? We found out we was brothers like 5 weeks ago. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I was like, you know, I'm the best DJ in America right now, Montay. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to get on a record, and I'm going to rap it right now. No, I'm just playing.
You can't tell. We look alike. See? You know. This is my best side right here. You know what I'm saying?
See the tap, my tap. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we look just alike, bro. We look just alike. We look like brothers, for real.
So what's up, man? Shout out to everybody that's on Hype Man Ricky IG Live interviews. We got the homie, my brother, DJ Montay. I'm saying it right?
Yes, sir.
I'm saying it right. See, everybody be saying I'm saying it wrong. So I'm like, you know what? Shut their face.
Nah, it's Montay. DJ Montay. Yes, sir. You're right.
So tell the people where you from, who you are, where you from, the people that don't know who you are, sir.
DJ Montay, man, from Atlanta, Georgia, representing Big Oomph Records, Oomph Camp, if y'all know what that is, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm here.
What's up, man? So how long you been producing?
I've been producing, I've been in the music industry for 27 years, so. Mm. Yeah, and been producing for probably like, I want to say 20 out of 27 years, so 20 okay. years out of 27, yeah.
All right. How long you been DJing, though, like? Doing your DJ
27 years still going. I started at a young age, so you know what I'm saying, so I've been doing it for a while
now. You produced a lot of hits, man.
I mean
I know you got plaques. I know it's plaques everywhere in that house,
right? It is running out of space right now.
You're running out of space.
For real. Yeah, I'm gonna have to make some room up in here some kind of way.
Jesus Christ.
I know, well, man.
How many triple platinums you got?
Triple platinums? I got two double platinum records, Walk It Out of Two Step, and I got a diamond record. Man. Yeah.
How was that early 2000 movement for a lot of people? Because, see, Atlanta, y'all was doing it.
Oh, man.
How was it?
It was a party, you know what I'm saying? Like, around 2000, you couldn't do nothing but party because that's all the music it was. You had your Booty Shake, you had your Kilo, you had your Kids of Rock, your DJ Smurf, and then you had your Snap music. You had your Franchise Boys, D4L, Us, Walk It Out, and we still had the Crump music with John, Baby D, all that kind of shit. So, man, the party scene in Atlanta was just fun, man. You had music for everybody. You had your Twerks music, Yin Yang Twins, and all that kind of shit, so... Man, music was just super fun in Atlanta, man. You know, it's still, man, it's all right now, but.
It's all right. Yeah,
it's all right. You're a DJ, so you can kind of listen to the music now.
Yeah.
It's just kind of, you know, it ain't, you ain't got your shit for the women. Like, Juvenile back that ass up kind of shit. All
they that. No more. It's like, yo, I'm going to show some money at you.
Yeah.
They're here.
Yeah, niggas ain't making music for the women no more. I don't get it. Unless they dogging their ass out. That's it.
Yo, it used to be a time when the girls used to be twerking. Brothers used to be like, oh shit.
See, look, my brother Infamous was saying it was fun. Yeah, DJ Infamous.
Shout out to Infamous, man. I got to talk to him too.
Oh yeah, he got that record out, man. You know, shit, that shit crazy. That shit dope.
Hey, tell him, Montay, he better holler at me.
Hey, look, he gonna get that shit ASAP for sure. I know he is. That's how we work. That's how we work. But nah, man, it was fun back then, though, for real.
Okay, so who was your inspirations coming up as a producer, DJ?
Well, as a DJ, I'm gonna say I had a lot of influences, but really, what took me over the top was Jelly. DJ Jelly took me just like this is what I want to do. DJ Jelly, MC Assault. But I grew up listening to like Kizzy Rock, Edward J, and all that kind of stuff. And then, you know, Jelly came with the mix where I was like, man, I got to do this. This is something I want to do for real. Like, right. I got to do this. Mm. And so that's what took me on the top as far as production. I mean, as far as DJing production, I always was making beats. So I always wanted to do it. I never knew how bad I wanted to do it, but I looked up to like 3-6 Mafia that had dope ass shit back then.
Oh,
you
know, Hypnotized.
All that. Oh, man. I was in love with goddamn 3-6 Mafia. I ain't going to lie to you. Like, I got them. The whole, they beats, everything was just super crazy. And then, shit, man. That's it, really, like, as far as production. And Dr. Dre and all that. Dr. Dre had me goddamn. That's I love them. Hold on. Y'all see who that is?
Tell them we in here. Tell them we in here. We in here. Goddamn.
Yeah, I got folks ringing my doorbell. I don't even know who's supposed to be
shooting
coming
my room up doorbell, too, same time. I look like this, like, who the hell coming to my house? Nobody comes see me.
Yeah, nobody coming over here like, who the fuck? Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, pretty much. Like, you know, I had to run to the door. I had to put you on pause for a second.
Hold up, nigga.
Yeah, man, you know.
So, Montay, man, like, it's hard to explain. So, who's the, give me five, all the artists you work with, I know were fire. What was your best artists that you worked with that just got in the booth and just nailed everything?
Future. Future do that. Pain do that. T-Pain do that. 2 Chainz did the same thing. Shit. Man, it's just a little bit everybody. T.I. did. It's like, I like all of them. Everybody different. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I just can't really just point my hand like, hey, man. But the fastest is Future. Future getting come up with a whole song in like 30 minutes for real.
I'm gonna keep it fun. That was your motherfucking ass. I knew it was you.
What?
Every other week he had a fucking album out.
Nah, that wasn't my fault though.
That was your fault.
I only did 2 records with Future, and I did Back on E and I Know Keys.
I'm telling you. Tell the truth. It was your fault.
Nah, man. That man was dropping music left and right, man. No, shout out to Rocco and Future. Them. They just set the bar on that Atlanta shit. They took it to a whole nother level then.
Yeah. Because, man, Future, he was doing his thing.
Yeah, he was.
I mean, he's still doing his thing now, but
definitely.
Shit. Yeah. You had everybody was like, yo, you get that new Future? What? It's out. I'm like, yo, you just gotta get it.
Gotta get it.
Our game's pumping.
Yeah.
Them records, man. Yeah, you have some dope records, man. You worked with T-Pain. Now, how many songs could you produce? Like, how many hours did you stay in the studio a day working with these artists? Like,
how many albums?
Hours.
Oh, shit. It's just the vibe. You know, me and Pain, you know, being there all day, depending on what we're coming up with. It might be like, shit, I might play him 5 beats and he'll run through them. See what he come up with, then he'll go in the booth and just start doing hooks, and he'll go shoot, load up the other one. Like, we did that, like, one time, 3 days straight, so that's just how it is working with him. He come up with dope hooks all the time.
So you walk in the club, you know, you and Shantae, and then y'all walk in the club, you know what I'm saying? Bubbly, yeah, what's up, y'all? Your song come on.
Right.
What's your reaction to when your music come on in the club? Like, you hear something you produce, you're like, oh, okay. Like, what's your reaction to that?
Man, my reaction, because I've been seeing it for so long, I really don't even have one.
Like, when your first time, the first time you heard your song in the club.
Man, it was amazing, because you just see everybody doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it would walk it out. Like, when that shit just hit big, you know what I'm saying? Everybody in the club just dancing. So that was just, like, one of my favorite moments. And then, really, I ain't gonna say this was a club, but I was in Canada and they played the Florida Low record, man. You gotta just see the whole crowd just jumping around, just the whole crowd, bro. That shit just big for me. So that never surprised
me. I know that international love is something real.
Something real. Like we always had love overseas. Like Germany is like my second home for real. So we always got love overseas.
Shoot, my uncle was telling me about Australia. He said, because, you know, they love them throwbacks out there in Australia. He was like, you got to come out here and get that money out here. Like,
Australia, dope. I was on a 2-week tour with T-Pain out there, and it's just like being over here for real.
Mm.
Like the whole country. I mean, the whole country is just like Atlanta. Except for if you hit a deer on the side of the road, it's out there. It's like kangaroos. It's like you'll see the kangaroos as the deers out there. So I'm like,
I ain't going front. Montay, one day when I was living in Virginia, I was trying to hit every animal.
I
hit a dog. I hit a fucking skunk. I was trying to hit all them niggas. There's the road.
Are you trying to hit them? Oh my God.
You know why? I was trying to get revenge because my boy had a dog that ran up on the fucking screen, thought he wasn't going to bite niggas.
Oh,
I said,
all
right. So what's the life of Montay? What does Montay do on his extracurricular time when he's not producing or writing or DJing? What's the life like for you?
I really don't have no extracurricular time because for me, like, my mind is always on go. My mind never really rests, so I'm always trying to do something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Shantae be like, man, why don't you just sit down and chill? I can't. Like, even on a chill day, I can't. Like, my mind is, shit, I might come up with a beat or something in my brain. I need to go downstairs right now. I'm in the mood. Like, that's just how I am. Or I want to do a mix CD, or I'm always doing radio. Radio is Monday through Friday, 8 to 9. On Hot 107.9, so I still.
You got to get me on there one day, man.
Hey, shit, I'll turn you on. That's all I can do. shit. My boy Tap Money, man, he got me on there every day, Monday through Friday.
That's what's up, man. Because I know when us DJs, a lot of us DJs, during this time, we all caught that anxiety. Some of us caught that anxiety, like we ain't want to touch shit, we want to do shit. And our women had to make us do something. My sister made me go outside.
Well, I worked out outside, so you know, shit. I stayed outside during this quarantine shit. I couldn't just sit in the house like that because my mind just stay busy. But shit, this year was like the really most chill year ever for me. So I was just being able to chill and just drink or whatever.
All we can do, you know?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He's in the house all year, goddamn, drinking like a fool. I don't even drink that much. Shit.
So, now, have you planned, like, how was it like working with, like, all the remixes? Because you got a lot of remixes to those records, the ones I was just playing, like, with Bow Wow and Jim Jones, all them people. What was it like working with those artists too?
Which one? What, like
the remix of Walk It Out with Jim Jones?
Walk It Out with Jim Jones. Oh, Andre, really? We had everybody verse. Like we had Jim Jones. Well, really, that was it. But then Andre would like pull up. We had sent him the instrumental because he was like he wanna do something to it if he can catch a vibe. So he rolled around and listened to it. Rode around, and he said, y'all pull up. So I pulled up to the studio, man, and man did that. As soon as I walked in there, he like, doo, 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 doo. And he just freestyled the whole shit.
That's
like,
stuff.
He did like 5 takes, and that was it. I was like, oh,
Me and my boy was arguing one day, because that was like, it was a long time ago, Montay, and we was talking about how come when you hear an artist, like say you hear T-Pain on all these records, does that mean he coming out with another album? What that mean? So everybody don't know when they see an artist on a lot of songs, what does that mean? Are they dropping a new album or they got a new songs coming out? What does that mean?
It means they running up a bag. Shit, if you got, like, let's just say Plies wanted T-Pain on Shout and, you know, shit, he getting money. You know what I'm saying? All them features either is a favor or it's some money. So shit, he getting some money. It don't necessarily mean he coming out with an album, but it helped. with the album if he's coming out with one. You know what I'm saying? Right. He's doing amazing features like that and shit. So it don't necessarily mean that, but you know, shit, niggas just running up a bag. Or they just doing favors for, like, shit, bro, I need you on the record. All right, bet, let's do it. That type of shit.
So for those people, you know what I'm saying? Because there's a lot of people that don't know records, man. And I'm tired of telling the ass. Because I did a whole Dirty South set one day, man. And I said, listen, I ain't going to keep telling y'all what these people, this dude did, man. Mm-hmm. My boy Montay has the hottest the hottest records of the early 2000s. One of the let them walk it out. You had it in a movie.
Yeah, it's been in a lot of stuff. It's been on movies, toys, all kind of shit.
Now, do you still give? They give y'all royalties for that shit, don't they?
Yeah, sir.
Man, yeah. You don't deserve that song. Is in Stomp the Yard.
Yes, you get it every time it hit the movie. I mean, every time it come on TV, all that shit. So that's how it be.
Can I co-sign with you?
Go ahead.
Come on, man. Can I co-sign and be like, I was part of that song?
It's a little too late, but you can. Come on with it.
Damn. Shoot, man. Now, I don't know if I got permission to play the song because a lot of people, you know how Instagram is.
Yeah, so,
But if you give permission, then it's cool. I can play this for the people, man, that don't know.
Knock yourself, I don't know what you're going to play, but knock yourself
out. I'm about
out.
To play Walk. Can I play the original Walk It Out or the remix? Which one?
I like the remix, man. Andre told everybody to take their shirts two, three sizes down or something like that. That was everybody changed it up then. Yeah, you know, shit, that was a game changer.
Yeah, what was it like working with on that song? It was just straight. Everybody got straight to the point.
Well, it was just me, Andre, and the engineer. There wasn't no one else in there, and he was like, shit.
Oh, the other one sent their verses.
Yeah, everybody else sent their verses in. Big Boy sent his verse in. Jim Jones, he was in New York, so he sent his verse in. So, shout out to my boy D. That he made that happen, you know, with Jim Jones, because we was all label mates. Jim Jones and Unk, so we were label mates. So that's how we was able to get that.
All right. So, without further ado, you want to introduce this song to the people out there?
Hey, man, if you don't know this song by now, then you got them really behind you, like in the 1990s or something. But this is Walk It Out Remix. It's the Walk It Out Remix, man. Y'all check it out. Andre 3 Stacks. We had to pull him out of retirement on this one.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey.
Now walk it out.
Hey. Hey. Like a Usher.
If you say real talk, I probably won't trust you. If you want to go to war, the guns, my pleasure. Even Jesus had 12 disciples on the level. Shrimp, whatever. He don't want now, they get 3,000. Like you're new to this part of town. Your white teeth will to me look like a nightgown.
This ain't too soft. You see what I'm saying? That was a game changer right there, man. It's so hard.
If it was considered a classic before the drastic change in production, when carbon metal instead of plastic value is what I'm talking about. Take to it easy and walk it out. You'll be the reason they chalk it out. You can't be the king in the parking lot forever. Not saying I'm the best, but till they find something better, I am here. No fear. Right here. Hey. Till then, I walk it out. 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 I wish I walk it out. I wish I walk it out. I wish I walk it out. Then east I walk it out.
Nationwide, tell them.
walk it out. Please walk it out.
That shit was hard. Yeah.
This shit is crazy. Then you drop it. No, we don't walk it out. We drop that bullshit out. I hopped out, flossed out. I bring my air forces out. I'm blowing purple smoke. I cough it out. Boil it up, then boil it out. Tap the bottle, pour it out. Bowling. We'll fade away. Then we can skate away. Tell the hopes I'll be late today. Oh, I can thug it out. I'll start studded out. I'll take it from up to Louis Luggage out. I'm talking Magic City or even Body Tap. You know that money ain't a thing. We throw a thousand stacks. Oh, yeah, we toss it out. You know what I'm talking about. We kept them status in the house. You know New York is out. Now walk it out.
I'm still, because I've been going through crazy shit. What is the song that you worked on? When you worked with Jeezy, you only worked on it with one track. How many tracks have you ever done with Jeezy?
I worked with Jeezy before he dropped the first album that everybody know. I think it was Post on the Corner, something like that. Mm-hmm. I did one on there.
Which one was that?
I forgot the name of it. I had to look it up, but I did one on that, and then I did Goldmine that came out on Trap or Die 3. Me, Randy, and then I got two on the new album that just dropped, the Recession 2. Did the Ooh Lord and the Ghetto.
Mm.
Yeah,
because I saw LeBron in the car. Now yeah. You got King James. Fucking King James playing your track. I know you're like, wait a minute.
Hey, man, that shit had me so lit. I was so goddamn. You know, that's one of my favorite NBA players. Right,
yeah, now. Mine's too, man.
Yeah, just to see LeBron doing that, man, I was geek. Shoot, I ain't gonna lie.
Shoot, you be like, look, LeBron, you better send me some motherfucking shoes, rings, something.
Man, something, goddamn. Something, you know, hey. But no, that shit was mind blowing for me. I was just happy to see that shit for real.
Right, man. So you like now do a lot of when the world was open, did you do a lot of community events, like giving back events to people for the community?
Early on in the Big One Record times we did, yeah. But you know, lately I've been in the studio just making beats and shit like that. So I haven't really even thought about that like that. Right. For real.
Okay.
Not even all gonna right, lie.
So now
I'm big for doing that, but I just never, I haven't done it recently.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So yeah, cause a lot of people, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on right now and you're in Atlanta right now.
Yeah, definitely.
With the big Senate race going on, people got to vote.
All that, but it's still community stuff going on. You know what I'm saying? Right. There's always room to give back. It's just, I haven't really been focused on
all that
stuff.
So being that we was in this pandemic and the world had shut down, I mean everything just stopped. How have you kept working? How have you managed to keep your mind flowing and working during this pandemic?
For me, you know, everything is production for me. So we got a website called mixtapemobsters.com.
Mm-hmm.
And MOBSTAZ mixtapemobsters.com, and we got all our old mixes to our new mixes right now up on there. So that's what we've been working on, building that, and I've been doing mixes for that. And so that's what I've been working on, and I've been doing production. And then that's what me and Jeezy came up. We've been working in the studio for at least about 3 or 4 months before the album came. So I was doing that too. So just making beats and staying productive while I'm in this house. Not letting Shantae drive me crazy.
Yeah, you know, Shantae like my radio show in the daytime. Yeah. And my slow jam. Y'all, everybody love my slow jam Sunday. So I'm killing that shit. I'm like, look, man, this slow jams, bro. Ain't nothing.
Hey, man. That's dope. I love some slow jam.
Shoot, man, Sunday. You know what's so crazy, Monte?
Not during the day, though. I like some slow jams at night. It had to really be late.
Yeah, man, because shoot, you need that. Yep. Shit, you need that, because some people just can't sleep without some music sometimes, and some people just need that music, but you know.
Yeah.
so, it's an honor to be having, like, a lot of people from all over listening to my show. I I'd be like, yo, this shit is crazy. I think freaking Funk Flex was listening to my show.
Oh, wow. Said, that's huge. That's huge for you, bro.
I literally laughed. I said, wait a minute. I said, let me make sure this ain't no damn scam or joke. I was just tagging people. I think I tagged you or somebody, too. I was like, yeah, tune in my slow jam. He's like, I'm going to tune in at 10 o'clock. I said, fuck. You don't be talking to me like that. You just repost what I tell you.
Yeah, shit. Pain popped up in here while you were talking to
Shantae.
Yeah.
I hit him up again, man. He hit me back. So I was like, man.
Yeah, he bad in the DM, so I ain't going to lie to you. He don't even hit me back like that, but that's my dog.
He got a texting service. I said, what? Yeah. Text me back like 5 days later.
Boy, said, that's right. That's how it be. That's how it be, goddamn shit.
So now, are you working on a brand? Like, are you working on any kind of a clothing line or any brand?
Nah, I ain't doing a clothing line right now. Really, pretty much, I'm focusing on helping getting big on record artists off the ground right now. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, for me, my mind is, I really have to stay focused on one thing. I can't really do too much at one time. Yeah. Right. Something ain't gonna get done, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or something gonna get forgotten. So I just stay focused for right now on doing that. You know, I told myself I want 10 more of them Get Low records. So that's my that's my achievement for right now. And I believe I can do that in like 2021. So
that's what's up. So Big
Oomph. Salute, brother.
Who's under that record label?
Big Oomph.
Big Oomph, yes. Who's all under that record label?
So from the past, you had Intoxicated, Sammy Sam, Baby D, and Loco the Lunatic. And then now you have Shantae Renee, DG Chuck, J Tiz, Kathy Cool, Chico. You got Quay, you got Wix, you got Big Corey, his son. So it's a lot of people that we just working on right now.
I would like to have them artists.
Oh yeah, come on, man. Hey, look. Yeah, we working on records right now. You know what I'm saying? We're stacking the catalog. So that's what we're doing. Yeah, it's coming. The new one's coming.
Let's go. So now, what upcoming projects do you have coming up for your fans out here in Atlanta and Jersey and New York? What upcoming projects you got coming up?
Oh, right now we're just working. You know what I'm saying? I just ain't did no placements as of right now because, you know, it's kind of the end of the year, so I ain't got nothing coming up right now. I got a lot of, I don't really don't like to say until shit finna come out. So
right.
I just had to keep that on chill for a second. On
chill mode? Like,
yeah. I got a couple more coming, but I don't want to say it until this shit is like finalized.
Finalized, okay. Yes, so sir. When 2021 comes, just know that it's gone.
It's going to be wild. All the way up. All the way up.
What I'm talking about, man. So yeah, yes, man. So, somebody else told me, one of my boys told me to ask you, are you looking for any artists right now? Are you looking to, if any artists come up to you now and say, yo, can you produce one of my records? Are you looking to produce anybody records right now?
Yeah, I know I do production for folks, but you know, shit, as far as us looking for artists, it had to be something different, somebody dope. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie to you, I'm real picky when it comes to artists or listening to songs and everything like that. So it's just gonna have to be a real dope ass artist.
Okay. So how do you feel about the rap game right now? What's going on right now? How do you feel about how you know, there's a little the beefs and how all this social justice and all the stuff going on? How you feel about the rap game right now?
Right now, I feel like there's a lot of shit sounding the same, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just wish this was just a little diverse. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit, man. You know, everybody got the same drum kits. Everybody got the same everything. You know, so mm-hmm. I just want something just a little different. That's all.
Shout to Ray Lavender.
My boy Ray, what's happening, brother?
That man.
Goddamn New Zealand in the building. What's up?
Yes,
what's up?
Shout what's out up? To New Zealand.
Yeah.
Shit. Oh, my God, yo. Somebody. It's heavy out here. So, yeah. Man, so, yeah, somebody asked, now, damn, can I talk to the guy? I know he did two-step, and I heard you play. What the fuck? Hey, somebody get mad at me in the Instagram, not Instagram, but Facebook comments, because they on the show too, listening. So, do you mind if I play Two Step for these goddamn people?
Yeah, as long as it's the remix, I don't know.
Oh, yes, it's the remix.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah, that it's, remix.
Oh, so you did a lot of the remixes.
I did everything. I did his whole first album.
Man.
Yeah, I did his whole first album. Man. Hey, Shantae.
Shantae, what's up, Shantae? And I'm mad about you. Mad at you, Shantae. You supposed to hook me up with that girl you said you had.
Oh, God.
She never do it. Me and T-Pain been waiting for a hookup with you.
Man, oh, God.
Messing with her, man.
That's funny.
You know what? You know what? Let's play her record.
It's all good with me. Play that shit, too.
All right. You know what? Let's play Shantae record. You. Produced by you.
Nah, it's actually produced by New Drip, one of our producers on the On Camp. Yes, sir.
Okay. My bad.
No, it's all good. It's all good. I like to give my credit to my people because, you know, they work hard.
That's what's up, man.
I don't like to take all the credit, so.
Okay. So, look, man, we're going to play Shantae Renee's record. This is called You.
You. Yeah.
Like you.
You. Yeah.
So, let's get to it.
Hypemanricky.
Hypemanricky.
I try to do it.
I see you, man.
Yeah. You're the only one, baby. Shantae Renee. Let's go.
You're the only one that can get me in my feelings. And I'm not with you, boy. That's a crazy feeling. You're the only one I want to
meet.
Look how many weeks. 24 weeks.
Crazy. You see that? That's called working.
Yes, sir.
And all the others been lurking. But you ain't gotta worry because I know you. And everybody know I'm your girl. Since day one, it's you and me, baby. We gon' ride to the end. We gon' make it. Can't nothing come between us ever. I'm your queen, that's forever, ever. It's all about you. It's all about you. It's all about you, baby. It's all about you, baby. It's all about you. It's all about you. It's all about you, baby. It's all about you, baby.
We here.
Mm-hmm.
We here.
Step into the right, wipe me down, man. Step into the left, just on the frame. Body's time, the world, know what you do. It's going down, so step and read me. I'm back with my jeans, put another one. Two-step again, jiggy, baby.
Hey. Yeah. Here, bang. Hey. What up, Jazz?
He fought it.
Shining like a chandelier.
Leer.
Up in my ear. Sick with a trophy on my neck. I dang near where it ain't. Why? Too much candy on my ride. Too many rumors I didn't die. Too many haters on this earth. All my life it ain't been searched. Started off real small, but now my mail is tied. And a walk before I brought, I had my back against the wall. Two faces not up, two faces at once. Gritting and getting it in. Hustles are up, never no pause. Two step on your chest. I see some brides. Two step, everybody lost.
Club Ranch, goddamn.
Yo, I snapped on this.
Oh, he bought it. Oh, yeah, he killed that shit.
That man, yo.
Yeah, E40 blessed us with that one.
Man.
Water.
E40 verse Too Short. I said, what?
Now, that's going to be amazing. Goddamn, the Bay Area, you're finna go crazy
the
on
Bay,
that one.
Man.
Yeah, wow, they can go crazy with that.
That's gonna be something like, I'm gonna be like, So you wanna be a gangster? I think that's a Too Short made. You wanna be a gangster?
Well, shit, that the Ghetto is one of Too Short old records, but it still came from an old sample. But that's right. How we did on Jesus shit. But we added E40 on there. That shit was hard.
That's what's up, man.
Yeah.
Yo, do you have any contact information for anybody that want to contact you for any features on anything? Or
Hit my email. I got an email in my bio on my Instagram. Y'all can hit me up. I always check it every day. So hit me up through that or hit me in the DM. One or the other. Goddamn, so.
What days you on 107?
I'm on 107 Monday through Friday, Atlanta. 107, 8 to 9. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So here's my part of the segment. If you know anybody that wanted to get in the game of rapping, singing, producing, whatever, what inspiration words you can give that person if they wanted to get in?
Get out and work. This is all a grind. This shit don't happen overnight, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, this shit really is all a process. It's all steps. You got to get out and network. Fuck with folks until they start fucking with you. So, you know, you got to stay at it. I know it can get a little discouraging sometimes or get frustrated because, you know, you're not where you want to be or you see everybody else on Instagram or however it is doing this, but it took them a minute. You never know their grind. You never know their story. So I just say keep pushing, really, at the end of the day. What up, Silver Knight, my brother?
That's what's up. And my brother, matter of fact, in here named BG, he actually put me onto that two-step song at a game.
Damn, for real?
DJ, you're playing two-step. I was like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
Two step. Yo, that shit is real. It was wild, man. It's wild that I'm talking to you because I'm like, yo, this stuff never. And I can imagine back in the early 2000s if I was still doing this and I interviewed. What?
Yeah, back in the day, it wasn't no internet, though. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't internet, but it wasn't no like this.
Like this. Yeah. No, they. Mm-hmm. You have to see them in person. You got to fly.
One no FaceTime, one no nothing. You had to fly to every city and do an interview. Yeah, so that's how it was. Yeah.
Ooh, and I was scared to ride planes.
I be telling everybody, y'all, like artists right now, pretty much got it easy. It's your grind and your hustle. See, years ago, we had to send CDs and vinyls to DJs by mail. We had to have everybody mailing address. And we carry the box to the goddamn post office to send off records.
Oh, that shit used to be so frustrating.
Yeah, wasn't no emails, wasn't no nothing. It's like we had to send records out through, unless you, you know, if you're in a different state or something like that. That's how we had to send out records.
Wow.
Yeah, mailing addresses. You
know, that was freaking annoying.
Hey, man, shit, that's what happened.
The bag.
Yeah, hey, look, it was all worth it for us.
Shoot, it definitely was, because you see the you see the wall.
Yeah,
could you show the wall one more time, like, to a couple people that don't see what you got on that wall?
Hold on, let me see. God damn, I can't even put this. Oh, there you go. Ah, fuck.
Okay, do y'all see these plaques on the wall? T-Pain, DJ Unk. What? Yo, do y'all see these plaques?
Yeah, I got plaques, and I got some out in my hallways and shit like that too. So,
yeah,
like there's one out in the hallway, and some more out there. So, by my door, they all around the house. It's just,
man, listen, bro.
Yeah,
that's crazy. That's crazy.
Yeah, this month. My goddamn screen won't let me flip back over. This shit's so stupid.
Anyway. I hate this screen. I hate IG. It's damn annoying. Let's see where's Uncle Montay. He probably coming back. That's legendary plaques on the wall. Like, literally, plaques. Double platinum. Like, hits. For y'all that don't know. I mean, make sure y'all following me too on here. If you ain't following me, you definitely ain't winning. I'm gonna bring him back though. You gotta bring him back. Let me bring him back. Bring him back. Cause the IG be acting like another dimension.
Yeah, I'm back.
Yeah, IG be acting like another dimension now. I wouldn't be surprised when Clubhouse start getting freaking lives, then I'm like, oh god. But yeah, man,
diamond. So she want me to show this one off real quick. Hold on.
Okay, let's see. See, people, when I tell you, look at that. For freaking Flo Rida, he did the song for Flo Rida.
Yep, diamond.
None of y'all wouldn't know that he did the song with Flo Rida. Mm-hmm. Low.
Yeah, just got that award. That was like a birthday present for me. I just got that one in.
Flo Rida. What's up with Flo Rida these days?
Man, that man has sold so many records. People, he went totally pop. Like, shit.
He went
a lot of records.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That dude, he did it smart, too. He went to that college crowd, all that crowd, because people was blasting that low. Every freaking party.
Hey, man, you ain't got to tell me. I've seen so many YouTube videos and everything.
I used to have twerk contests with females playing that damn song. Hey, it was fucking twerk.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Shoot, they done made Jersey Club songs to that song.
Man, that record done did a lot of things and it's still doing it. It just was in like a Kroger commercial or something. But the animation was dropping low and all that shit. That shit was so fun.
Crazy.
Yeah, that shit was amazing.
So Montay, this part of my segment, I like to have you give your shout outs and do what you want. This is your part of the segment. It's all about you. Shoot 'em.
Man, first shout out to God, man. You know, without God, none of this would be possible. And then two, big shout out to my mom. She's been a big support for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, she just didn't know where this was going for me. So she just allowed me to be me. And I appreciate her for that. And then big on MC Assault and DJ Jelly, man. And the whole Oomph count, man. Just shout out to everybody, you know. And now my supporting family, everybody. My sister, she and him, one of my biggest fans. So, you know, shit, everybody.
Shout out to Barbara?
No, my life is Jazzy. That's my sister.
Okay, I see it right there. She said mic drop.
Yeah, when I show her. She's so crazy. Yeah, but that's it, man. You know, everybody that's around, that's my friends, everybody, man. Shout out to everybody that supported Big Ol' Brothers, DJ Montay, DJ Jelly, MC Salt, man, Oomph Count, everything. Shout out to everybody.
Once again, you hear.
Yeah.
Hear from one of the best DJ producers in the game now. Hey, 27 it, years killing it.
Yes, sir. Appreciate
people don't
appreciate
get it, man. Yo, we definitely got to get – you got to get me them artists, man.
Oh, yeah. When we're ready to go, I'll let you know.
You're gonna be Dude, I'm ready to shoot for the big leagues now. I'm trying to get T-Pain, Jeezy. I'm trying to get them all.
Good luck. I'll be trying to FaceTime that fool. He don't answer the phone sometimes. You know, you had to catch him at a good moment.
Yeah, man. Them dudes be all over the place.
All over the place.
Oh, man. But once again, I want to thank you, Montay, DJ hey, Montay, for doing this interview with me, man. Mm-hmm. My brother. Love you,
yes,
man.
Sir. Love you
winning
too,
out there. Appreciate doing it. What you do. Stay yes, safe. Sir. Wear your mask.
Got to. Got
and you know, when we get to that other side, See?
Got the mixtape monster mix. Yeah, I keep the mask.
Dang, man. That's...
I got some DJ Montay masks around here somewhere. They probably in the garage somewhere, but yeah.
So, look.
You're welcome.
Stay safe, man. Yeah. And when the world open back up, you know we all hooking up.
Oh, yeah, let go, man. You know, I'm there.
I'm
What's
coming
you to you in again?
Jersey, Patterson, New Jersey.
Oh yeah. Shit, I'll be everywhere. So I hit you when I'm there too. Or if you in Atlanta, hit me up.
Oh yeah, I was in Atlanta last year, and somebody I haven't been there. I wasn't there for like more than 2 days. As soon as I put up a post, I'm in Atlanta. Hella people hit me up. Yo, you in Atlanta? Yo, you want to come to this? You want to ditch? I don't have my equipment. No, just bring your laptop. How you know I got my laptop?
I know. DJs carry their laptop.
Yo.
It don't even matter if you got going on vacation. You got your laptop.
My boy was like, yo, Rick, you ain't been here for 1 day, and I had an interview.
Oh, wow. Shit, that's dope, bro. That's dope. That's how you supposed to be, though.
Yo, I was like, man, I got to work. I'm at work.
God damn it, man.
Oh, shit. But once again. But I love Atlanta, man. It's a beautiful place to be, man.
Yeah.
Beautiful place for man. All right, bro, man. But once again, this I want to thank you for doing this interview with me. It's gonna be played back on YouTube. You know, send me those artists. I wanna talk to them soon. I wanna get their records dropping on my show. Let's get it popping, brother.
They're coming your way, man. I appreciate you.
Anytime, man. Tell Shantae, but I know she's still probably tuned in. Me and T-Pain have talked to you.
All right,
man. But once again, big shout out to you, brother. Stay up, all right?
All right, you too, bro. Appreciate it.
No doubt.
Yep.
That was DJ Montay. One of the, I just don't know, one of the biggest, dopest DJ producers in the game. Killing it. You seen the plaques, you seen the diamonds, you seen the double plaque trap. Look, no need to say no more. Make sure y'all check me out. 9 o'clock, Chazzo, Hypeman Ricky. Fuck with me.